Hi, I'm AJ, and thanks for taking the time to check out my video. If you're not a current subscriber, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. Also hit that like button because you're gonna like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Today, we're gonna talk about how to invest your first $100. And with your first $100, we're not actually gonna put that into the stock market or into real estate or anything of that nature. What we're gonna start with is our education first. Now, when I say education, I don't mean the traditional means of going to school, going to a community college or university. When I say education, I mean just learning in general and reading books on your own, going out and trying to learn new information, whether it's from a book or from a person you know that has experience in an area. So the focus of this video will actually be on education as far as books that I recommend that you purchase with your first $100 before you go into investing into the market, and to also help you think about the different types of jobs or careers that you want to go into. These are my top five. I wish someone had told me about these books sooner. The first book I would recommend, which you can find on Amazon for about $12, is The Millionaire Next Door. Now, in The Millionaire Next Door, the authors, they do a lot of research behind how millionaires behave and how they use their money, how they spend their money, things of that nature. And what they learn over the process of their research is that most people who are millionaires as far as their wealth, not having a millionaire income, so that means having an actual $1 million of assets. Now, the wealth could be in your home and other real estate like rental property, in stocks, retirement accounts, things of that nature. So all of the assets that you have minus any debt that you have. So of course, if you have $1 million worth of wealth, that means you have at least $1 million more in assets than you have in debts. In this book, they talk about the different career paths that you can take and where the majority of people who have the millionaire's wealth, what type of jobs they pick, how they spend their money, what they spend their money on, and things of that nature. So it's a really good book. It's the first book I would recommend for someone who's just getting started in investing, or for a teenager or a young adult, or someone that's just getting started with investing and they just want to know how to go about spending their money the proper way and not wasting their money on things that aren't actually going to help them in the long run. And what's great about this book is that it's not only people that have a super high income. They also mention people who make between $30,000, $40,000, $50,000, who are able to, based on certain behaviors, able to create a millionaire's wealth over time. The second book is The 4-Hour Workweek. And you can find this book on Amazon for around $16. Now, within this book, he talks about how to create side hustles and just businesses in general. So these could be businesses that eventually take over whatever your day job is as far as the amount of money you're making. And not only that, but how you can work only 4 hours a week and still have the type of income that you would have made when you were working 40 hours a week. And this is a great book. This is what actually motivated me to create the first website as far as trying to generate an income from it. And while it wasn't that successful, the things that I learned on the way of, one, just reading this book, and then through the process of creating the website and doing the research on advertising and different ways to receive payment, different types of payment structures, it was a great book, and I really recommend this for anyone, especially if you're trying to create your own side hustle. Now, the next two books are more focused on, now that you have made money and you're putting money towards savings, now what do I do with this money? So the next book is The Only Investment Guide You'll Ever Need. Yes, that's the title of the book. I'm not saying that it's the only investment guide that you ever need, but that is the title. And it could be the only investment guide that you will ever need. There are a lot of great points that they make in the book as far as not only investing, but also purchasing items for a discount. And how if you purchase items in bulk at a large discount, this is giving you a great return on your money, because not only are you getting a great discount, but over time, inflation degrades money. So a year from now, let's say you buy some tissue in bulk, you get it for 50% off. One, the tissue may cost more next year because over time, prices increase due to inflation. Not only that, but any money that you save will be worth less than it was last year. So not only are you getting a great price by buying at a discount, but you don't have to buy it next year when your money is actually worth less than it is today. In this book, they also discuss different ways of investing, also family planning and things of that nature. And this book is a great lead into the next book that we're going to talk about. So the next book is The Little Book of Common Sense Investing. And this book is by John Bogle, who is actually the creator of the index fund. And it basically talks about how index fund investing for 80 to 90% of people out there is the best route to go versus buying individual stocks or paying someone else to invest your money for you. And the reason why I say it's better for 80 to 90% of people out there, and I actually think it's a lot higher than that, is because even professional traders, you know, the people that you would pay to try to get a higher gain that you would be able to do on your own, 80 to 90% of them are unable to beat the stock market. So if you were to buy a total stock market index fund, an ETF, then you're doing better than 80 to 90% of the professional traders out there. So these are the people that are the heads of hedge funds, they're heads of the mutual funds. They are the people making decisions on what stocks your money is going to be invested in when you give your money to them. But if you were to put your money in an index fund, especially a total stock market index fund, then you're going to get the average of the market. And if you're getting the average of the market and 80 to 90% of professionals can't beat the market, then you're actually doing better than 80 to 90% of professional traders. So do yourself a favor and find this book on Amazon or wherever you buy your books. On Amazon, it's around $16 or $17 for this book. And you're gonna save a lot more in investment fees by reading this book versus going out and spending your money, allowing someone else to invest your money for you. Now, the last book isn't really about money specifically. This is more about behaviors. So the next book is called What Got You Here Won't Get You There. And you can find this book on Amazon for about $15. Now, the author of this book is actually a coach who helps CEOs and other high-end executives improve their leadership skills and how they interact with their employees and, you know, if they're a manager, people that are above them, if they're like a middle manager. And in this book, it talks about the different behaviors that when you are on a lower level, let's say if you were a sales guy or if you were an entry-level worker, and the things that helped you get the job that you're currently in, they won't help you go into higher ranks. Because there are behaviors like people that really love to win and they'll do anything to win. You can't do that once you're up in a higher management and executive level. Because the way people look at you is different, and the way that you can affect the people under you is totally different than when you're in an entry-level position. And out of the 20 behaviors that they talk about, he really asks you to only focus on 2 to 3 at the most, because if you try to change 20 different behaviors, it's really hard to do. So you really want to focus on what other people believe are the top 1 or 2 that you should work on. Because it's really not what you think you need to improve in yourself, it's what is perceived by other people is what you need to improve. If you would like a full list to see what those 20 behaviors are, make sure you check out the description. I'll put a link to his website and he has the 20 behaviors listed, but make sure you actually get the book, and he goes into explaining how all of those different behaviors are perceived by other people. Now, many of the behaviors in the beginning of the book, when he starts to list them out and just talk about the high level of what the behaviors are, I looked at many of those behaviors and I'm like, well, I don't do most of those, so I shouldn't really have a problem. But once he actually goes through each chapter and talks about how those behaviors are perceived by other people and what in their minds they believe that you're doing, that's when I was like, oh wow, a lot of these behaviors are things that I do. So it was really an eye opener to see how people perceive certain actions that we all do on a daily basis. And we don't really think about how those behaviors affect other people, or more so how they receive some of the actions that we take personally. Once you've purchased all of the books, whatever money you have left, which should be around $20 to $30, what I want you to do is open an account with one of the free trading companies. So there are a few apps out there where you can actually purchase stocks and ETFs and there is no commission fee. Take one of those apps. I've done a review on a few of those. Just to mention real quick, M1 Finance, Robinhood, SoFi Invest, and there may be others out there as well, but check those out. that way that you can maximize using the full $20 to $30 that you have left, and go out and purchase a total stock market ETF. Now, when you're doing this, you're investing in all of the public companies within the US. And if you invest with an app where you can buy partial shares, then you can invest the total amount of that $20 to $30. And I have videos going into who those companies are, and I have reviews of a few of those trading apps, so make sure you check those out. And once you finish reading those books, after that, I want you to then check your account and see how much money you gained, or what percentage gain you have on what you invested. And just make sure you come back and leave a comment below. If you've already read these books and you really like them, make sure you like this video. Also, leave a comment for any books that you think should have been in the top five. I do have a list of honorable mention books. So a few of the books that didn't quite make my top five were Rich Dad, Poor Dad, which is a really great book. The Richest Man in Babylon, The Power of Habit, Think and Grow Rich, and a book called Win, The Scientific Secrets of Perfect Timing. All of these are great books, and maybe for some of you, that would be in your top five. And if you have time later on, I definitely recommend all of those books. Now for a bonus. Now, if you're actually able to access these books for free, then you can actually invest the full $100. So if you're able to find these books at your local library, or if you check out my video where I talked about how you can access audiobooks for free, if your library has audiobooks for free, check them out there as well. And then you can invest a total $100 into a total stock market ETF. And then also, when you comment, let me know which route you went. If you purchased books through Amazon or some other website or bookstore, or if you found the books for free and you were able to invest the full $100 into a total stock market ETF. All right, guys, thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate you taking this time out of your day to watch this. If you're not a current subscriber, subscribe button is down below. Make sure you tap that. Also hit the like button because you know you like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Again, really appreciate you taking this time out of your day. Thanks, and have a great day. Thank you.